Hello and welcome everyone. This is a new episode of The World Today. We are going to discuss, as usual, a lot of headlines published on national and international websites. Before we start, let me first welcome our dear guest live here in the studio, Engineer Hassan Shaban, the leading member of the political party and our political analyst of this episode. Thank you very much for being with us, sir.
Thank you for inviting me.
And we are going to start from Al-Ahram Online, where we read, Egypt's foreign minister heads to Morocco. Is Cairo searching for a North Africa strategy? This is the question posed by Al-Ahram Online. Egyptian Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry heads to meet with the Moroccan king to sort out relations reportedly strained by low-level media wars and Algerian connections and differences on attitudes to Islamists. I will first, sir, if you permit me, have an objection on the word Islamists. We managed to know by ourselves for years now how when religion is mixed with politics, both are unfortunately in trouble, I should say so. Regarding this situation in specific, the media war, the Algerian connections, I think Sameh Shoukry went to Morocco with many things to tell and with many items on his agenda. If you were wearing his shoes, what would you do first, or what are going to be your priorities?
First of all, I would like, if I was in his shoes, actually, I would first clear the media war that started some time ago.
Late September.
Yeah, because it was, you know, not a very wise thing from both sides to start something like this in this particular, climate. The second thing, I would, I would talk to the Moroccans to contribute to the Egyptian efforts to solve the Syrian dispute. Because actually the Moroccans have excellent relations with Bashar al-Assad, the Alawis in Syria. So maybe the line of solution is not really directly from Cairo to Damascus. It might be Cairo, Morocco, or, you know,
Casablanca.
Casablanca, then to Damascus. Because the Alawis and the Moroccans have very close ties, because the Moroccans consider themselves Fatimids. So the Alawis and the Fatimids are brothers and cousins. So I think this is politics. It could work out. It worked out previously, and I think it could work out again.
I'm sorry for the interruption. I'd like here, if you permit me, to focus on the Egyptian-Arab relations, because Egypt is keen to have a balanced relation between Cairo and all the Arab capitals wherever. Whenever I'm talking to our relations with Algeria, they are very strong, and the first visit by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi to another country, it was Algeria, and there were talks between Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and Abdelaziz Bouteflika. But what happened recently from the Moroccans and from what happened on the state television of Morocco was a reaction of the boosted relations between Egypt and Algeria, or there are other things behind the curtain?
I don't think that, I think what happened is, has nothing to do with the state policy. Because actually we are trying to come up with a North Africa alliance, actually. And I think we're going to have to use the word alliance, because we need to face terrorism in the Sahara, next door to Morocco, next door to Algeria, next door to Libya, next door to us. We need to coordinate with France, because actually France do exist heavily in the Francophone countries in Africa.
And Spain.
Spain, well, we'll talk about this in a second, because actually Morocco have, they've always enjoyed excellent relations with Spain and with the French. But if we are looking for a military coordination, Chad yesterday announced that they're going to send some troops
already done to fight Boko Haram inside Nigeria.
And I think we have to be present in this whole thing. If we want to be present in Africa, we cannot turn our back to what's happening in Africa. Especially, there was a statement from the Minister of Foreign Affairs, the French Minister of Foreign Affairs. He said, yes, we do appreciate that Egypt has a terrorism problem, but the ways of facing terrorism are completely different from ours. This worries me, because terrorism is terrorism, whether it's in Egypt or in France.
But sir, if you permit me, if you would see the French army now deployed in the capital, Paris, and in many other places after the Charlie Hebdo, sad event, I should say, and I should confess it was a sad event, yet you would think that it's a deja vu, something which you have seen already in many of Egyptian cities. So I think whenever you are talking about a diplomat, a top diplomat, it's going to be totally different than a defense minister, or even Hollande, when he asked even his people to mandate him to fight terrorism, exactly as President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi did when he was only a field marshal or a defense minister.
You realize that John Kerry, Mr. John Kerry, met the mayor of Paris this morning and he had some talks with him.
And with Hollande.
And with Hollande, but what I want to say is the U.S. is a little bit scared that France might really go full heart with their North Africa.
It's not going to be might, inshallah. France will.
I hope so. Really. Yeah. You know, we enjoy excellent relations with France. I think President Hollande is very wise, and I think he realizes what we are facing in Egypt. It's very similar, maybe greater than what happened in France. I think the coordination between France and Egypt and Algeria will benefit tremendously in facing terrorism in the area.
Two sides of the Mediterranean. From Al-Ahram Online, we continue to read, Egypt's economic reform impressive, but more political steps needed. UK Minister, the UK has described Egypt's economic reform program as impressive, pledging to help the Egyptian government to implement reforms. The comments by UK Middle East Minister Tobias Elwood came at the conclusion of the minister's visit to Egypt on Friday, during which he met with the Egyptian president, with the head of the state, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and Elwood was accompanied by representatives from 46 corporations or companies from Britain, who said or assured the president that they are going to be here attending the economic conference, which is going to be held inshallah by mid-March in the resort of Sharm el-Sheikh. Sir, how do you see the timing of this visit and the comments by Edward?
Excellent, actually. I think the ball is in our court right now. We need to be to the rhythm of being prepared for this conference should be faster, more professional. Everybody is watching us. We need to utilize this conference to the best interest of Egypt. We need a good agenda. We need good contracts, pre-conference work to reach happy endings in the conference, not to use the conference as an event for speeches.
No, of course not. And regarding this, many presidential decrees took place today with amending some of the regulations which were taking place between Egypt and some international parties, and about the cotton. This is something you know more than I do. And also, even Edward said that this delegation he had in Egypt was the biggest ever in the history of Egyptian-British relations. But so before leaving this point, also as we speak now, high ranking officials are receiving Shinzo Abe, the Prime Minister of Japan, who is going to start his Mid-East trip from Egypt and is going to meet President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi also for more talks. How do you see the diversity of relations we have and the diversity of sources we have regarding especially Egypt?
I think this is a result for the very wise politics that President Sisi is following. He earned the respect of all the major and superpowers in the world today. Mm-hmm. We have the Canadians, the British, the Japanese. I mean, we had excellent relations with the Russians. We are moving ahead. I think, as I said, now it is the time to hit the steel while it's still hot. We need to utilize this to the best interest of Egypt, and we have an agenda, and we have a lot of items that could interest Japan for mutual benefit.
Yes.
In the very near future.
Mm-hmm. And tomorrow and the day after is going to witness a two-day visit by the head of state to the United Arab Emirates. Right after that, he is going to fly to Davos, to Switzerland, a very busy schedule indeed. And in a few weeks' time, we are going to be receiving, inshallah, Vladimir Putin, the Russian president. So a lot to speak about and a lot to witness in the coming few days and weeks. But let's move to our western gate, to Libya, and from Khalij Times we read. Libya peace talks continue after positive start. The talks are aimed at reaching agreement on a unity government to replace the rival administrations whose battle for power has left hundreds dead over the past 6 months. So,